So good morning everyone. As you all know that we are studying triangulation surveying in your surveying too. Okay. So the next chapter related to it is your theory of least error. So in that chapter the most important thing is related to the laws of the weight. So as you all know that in triangulation surveying what we have to do is to divide the areas into number of triangles, and from those triangle stations we used to take the number angles with the help of some theodolites. Okay, so the observations from the stations are done for a number of time, and a weight has been given to that angle. Okay, so this weight represent that how much accurately you have taken the measurement that this weight indicate, and there are certain laws of weight which we need to understand before starting the numerical related to your least square methods. Okay, so the first law of the weight is that it is saying that the weight of the arithmetic mean of measurements of unit weight is equal to the number of observations. So in triangulation surveying this chapter is very important because laws of weight most of the time it has been asked in your university exam, and there might be chances that in your MCQ question there might be some question related to your laws of weight. So this is very important, the weight of arithmetic mean of measurement. So what you have to do that these are the weights of your measurements. Okay, the angle A has been measured around 8 times or 6 times. It has been measured 6 times and certain weight has been given. So this weight of the arithmetic mean of measurements of unit weight is equal to the number of observations. So what you have to do is that you have to do the arithmetic mean. Okay, so arithmetic mean of what measurement? Arithmetic mean, you have to try to break this lines. Arithmetic means of measurement. So we have to do the arithmetic mean, that is 30 degree 20 minutes 8 second, because the first values are common for all the angles. So what you have to do, this is we are taking out common and we are adding what 8 second plus 10 second plus 7 second plus 10 second plus 9 second and plus 10 second, which is giving you 30 degree 20 minutes 9 second. Okay, so we have basically taken an average value of this. So that means what? The weight of unit weight is equal to the number of observation. So the weight which has been coming out after this calculation, the arithmetic mean, the whatever the value it has been coming out, its weight is equal to what? Its weight is equal to the number of observation, how many times you have measured the angle. So observation has been done by number of time in six numbers. So observation has been done for 6 times. So the weight of this value will be equal to what? 6. Okay, so this is how, that means this indicate that this is been taken out with the taking the average of these value. That means this weight will be more, obviously, because you have taken a number of observations from single station and you have taken the average value of that. So that will give you the more accurate result as compared to your weight which is having one value. So basically weight indicate what? The weight, if it is on the higher side, that means it indicate it is more accurate. If it is on the lesser side, it means it is less accurate. It basically indicate the accuracy of your angle. So this is the first law of your weight. The second one is the weight of the weighted arithmetic mean. Okay, so the weight of weighted arithmetic mean is equal to the sum of individual weights. So what we have to do is that you have to take what the sum of individual weight, because in the last line it is saying that it is sum of individual weight. Sum of individual weight will be what? 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 2. So the sum is 16, and the weight of the weighted arithmetic mean is equal to this value. Okay, so what you have to do is that we have to take the weight of the weighted arithmetic mean. You need to add all this value. Okay, 30 degree 20 minutes, okay, 8 second, 8 seconds. So whenever this type of term is coming out, weighted arithmetic mean, that means you have to multiply this angle with the weight. Okay, so you can see that 30 degree 20 minutes 8 second into what? 2. Okay, then 30 degree 20 minutes 10 second into 3. Okay, then 6 second into 2, then 10 second into 3, then 9 second into 4, then 10 second into 2. So this will give you the value as 30 degree 20 minutes 9 second. Okay, so this is the value. Okay, so this weighted arithmetic mean value, its weighted observation is equal to what? Its weight will be equal to 16. Okay, so in this way, the second law works, which say it is saying that the weight of the weighted arithmetic mean is equal to the sum of individual weights. So you need to add the sum of all the individual weight, and you have to multiply this with here this. Okay, and then these values been divided by this after multiplication. You will have to divide it by 16. Okay, so that will give you your accurate result. That is the second law of your weight. The next one. The weight of algebraic sum of two or more quantities. So when you are what adding two quantities, so the weight of that quantity is equal to the reciprocal of the sum of individual weight. So its weight generally becomes equal to what the sum of the reciprocal of their individual weight. So suppose this is the quantity, this is, there is alpha and there is beta. The alpha value is 42 degree 10 minutes 20 second, its weight is 4, and beta is 30 degree 40 minutes 10 second, and its weight is 2. So what it is saying that the weight of the algebraic sum of two more quantities. So what you have to do, this you have to add this value. You have to add this value alpha plus beta. So which is coming out to be 72 degree 50 minutes 30 seconds. Okay. So the whatever the value is coming, its weight will be equal to what the sum of the reciprocal of individual weight. So reciprocal of 4 will be what? 1 by 4. Okay. Plus the reciprocal of this value will be what? 1 by 2. Okay. So equal to the reciprocal of the sum of the individual, sum of reciprocal of individual weight. So this is the reciprocal and then the reciprocal of individual weight. 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2. That will give you the result. So the weight of this value is finally coming out to be 4 by 3 after doing calculations. Okay. So this is the third law of your weight. The next one, if it has been minus, it is also same. If the quantities has been minus, that is mean alpha minus beta, it is coming out to be 11 degree 30 minute 10 second, and its weight will be equal to what the reciprocal of the reciprocal of sum of the individual weight. So 1 divided by the reciprocal of the individual weight means 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2. Okay, so the final value is coming out to be 4 by 3. So in both case, addition and subtraction, the sum is coming out to be same. Okay, the next law of weight, it is saying that if the quantities of a given weight is multiplied by a factor. So if there is a quantity of a given weight, it has been multiplied by a factor, the weight of the result obtained by dividing its given weight by the square of the factor. So whatever quantity is coming out to be, its weight will be equal to what? Its weight is obtained by dividing its given weight. So whatever weight has been given, it has been divided by the square of the factor. Okay, by the square of the factor. So we will see this. There is alpha value, which is 42 degree 10 minute 10 second. Its weight is 6. Okay, so if it has been multiplied by a factor 3, okay, so the 3 alpha equals to what? 26 degree 31 minutes. So what it is saying that the weight of this result is obtained by dividing its given weight. So 6 divided by its given weight, okay, 6 divided by the square of the factor. So the factor which has been multiplied is 3, so 3 square. So this value will be is coming out to be 2 by 3. Next law of your weight is if quantity of a given weight is divided by the factor. So here it was multiplication, now it is division over here. The weight of the result obtained multiply is given weight by the square of the factor. So what if you have a quantity, this is the quantity alpha and the weight is 4, and if it has been divided by a factor 3, so its value is coming out to be 14 degree 3 minute 30 seconds. So it is saying that the result obtained is multiplying its given weight. So you have to multiply its given weight by the square of the factor. So the square of the factor is what? 3. Okay, so 4 into 3 square, that will give you 36. So this weight becomes what? 36. Okay. And next one, if the equation is multiplied by own weight, the weight of the resulting equation is equal to the reciprocal of the weight of the equation. So what you have to do is that if there is an equation and it has been what multiplied by its own weight, so you can see that there is an equation A plus B, which is 98 degree 20 minutes 30 second, and its weight is 3 by 5. So you need to multiply this 3 by 5. Okay. With A plus B, so this value is coming out to be 59 degrees 0 minute 80 second, is equal to what? Is equal to the reciprocal of the weight of the equation. So the reciprocal of weight of the equation, so weight of the equation is 3 by 5. Okay, so the final value will be what? This file will come up, which will be equal to what? 5 by 3. Okay, so in this way, this is a sixth law of your weight. The last one is the weight of an equation remains unchanged. So if the weight of the equation remains unchanged, if all the sign of the equations are changed, or if the equation is added to subtracted to added to or subtracted to from a constant. So it is saying that if there is any equation and if you are changing all the sign of the equation, then the weight does not change, it remains the same. And even though if you are adding a constant to it or subtracting a constant to it, the weight does not get changed. So A plus B is suppose 80 degree, 20 minutes, its weight is 3. Suppose you are minusing it with what? 180 degree. So its value is coming out to be 99 degree, 40 minutes. So its weight values does not change. Even though you are adding something or you are subtracting something, its value will not change. Even though if you change the sign of all the equation, the weight will be same. Okay. So these are the 7 law of the weights, which are very important for your exam point of view. At least one question will be related to this in your MCQ regarding your laws of the weight. So you need to remember all the laws of the weight, how does it works. Okay, so the next term in this chapter is related to the most probable value. As you all know that in triangulation surveying, we generally take number of observation from a single station. Okay, so since we are taking number of observation from a single station, which among them is having the most chances of being true, that we have to find out, and that is called as the most probable value. Okay, from suppose this is a triangular station, and if you have taken observation from this station and you have taken around 9 to 10 readings. Okay, so from 9 to 10 reading, you will have to find out which one reading is having the most probable value, that means which is having the most chances of getting true. Okay, that will be correct and true. That we need to find out by taking some calculation, and that we will do in our numerical. Okay, so as defined earlier, the most probable value of the quantity is the one which has more chances of being true than has to be other. Okay, it has to be done by several measurements and based with certain principles. Okay, so we'll try to find out the most probable value with the help of certain calculations. Okay, see over here, there is a numerical related to your most probable value. Okay, we'll try to understand this, what it is saying, that the following observations of three angles A, B and C were taken from one station. So you have taken three angles A, B, C were taken from one station. Okay, we are taking all the observation A, B and C from a single station. We have got this value A equals to what? 75 degree, 32 minute, 46 second, 0.3 with a weight of 3. B is having a weight of 55 degree, 9 minutes, 53.2 seconds. That is 2. C is what? 108 degree, 9 minutes, 28.8 seconds. The weight is 2. A plus B equals to what? 130 degree, 42 minutes, 41 second, 0.6. B plus C equals to what? 163 degree, 19 minutes, 22 second, 0.5. Its weight is what? 1. And A plus B plus C, the last equation is 328 degree, 52 minutes, 9 second, 0.8, which is having a weight 1. We need to find out the most probable value, okay, for each angle. Okay, so what you have to do in this type of question is that you have to take, I will do only one question related to this, okay, because there is very less chances that this type of question might be asked in your university exam. So I will teach only one numerical related to this. So in this, you can see that we have got a number of angles. Okay, so what you have to take, the corrections in the form of three values only. So let k1, k2 and k3 be the correction. So this is the correction we are assuming, because there are three angles, so we are taking three correction values, k1, k2 and k3. That is the most probable correction. Then the most probable correction value of ABC are what? Then what you have to do is that we are assuming that all the corrections are suppose positive. So A equals to what? 75 degree, 32 minutes, 46 second, 0.3 plus K1. Okay. then 55 degree 09 minutes 53 degree 53 second 0.2 plus k2 c equals to what 108 degree 09 minute 28.8 second plus k3. Okay, next what you have to do is you have marking this as equation number 1, this is equation number 2, this is number equation number 3. The next one is what, a plus b. Now what you have to do is that you don't need to take any of this value directly. You have to what, add this value 75 degree 32 minutes 46.3 plus 55 degree 09 minutes 43 second 0.2, that will give you this value 30 degree 42 minute 39 second 0.5. and because you are adding this, this is added with plus k1 and this is k2. Okay, so we are getting this equation by adding 1 and 2. Okay, next, the next equation is b plus c. What you have to do, you have to add this 55 degree 9 minute 53.2 second plus k2 plus your 108 degree 9 minutes 28.8 second plus k3. Okay, and similarly the last will be also that in this way only, you have to add this value, this equation plus this equation plus this equation. Okay, so we will get at least 6 equation in this, because number of the observation is how much, 1 2 3 4 5 6 observation will be there. Okay, so see over here, this is the 5th equation and this is the 6th equation. Okay, now what you have to do is that subtract this equation from the corresponding equation, we get the following observation. So what you have to do is that, so whatever equation you are coming you are getting, what you have to do is that you have to subtract it with the equation which was given in your question. Okay, so you will get the value as k1 equals to 0. How it is coming out to be k1 equals to 0, see over here. So you can see over here that if you minus this value with this value, okay, so the value will be what, because this is same as this value, so it will be what, 0. Similarly, if you subtract this value from this, the value will be what, 0. So k1 equals to 0, k2 equals to 0. Similarly, this value minus with this value, we will get what, 0. Okay, because this equation is same as compared to this. But in this case, the last equation, fourth equation, you can see that the value is not same. 30 degree 42 minute 39.5 second, and the value over here is 130 degree 42 minutes 41.6 second. So here there will be some value which has been coming. Okay, so after subtracting this equation, what the equation we are getting, this will be k1 equals to what, will be 0, k2 will be 0, k3 will be 0, but k1 plus k2 will be getting some value. Okay, so what value it is coming out, we will see in the next page. Okay, so k1 plus k2 after subtracting, we are getting as 2 second 0.1, weight is 2. Similarly, k2 plus k3, that was fifth equation, so its value is coming out to be 0 second 0.5, and k1 plus k2 plus k3 equals to what, 1 second 0.5. okay, 1.5 second basically, so its weight is 1. Okay, now what you have to do is that you have to find out the normal equation of k1. You will have to find out the normal equation for k2 and you will have to find out the normal equation for k3. Okay, so what you have to do is that normal equation is what, we need to multiply this with k1, so 3 k1. okay, we need to consider only those equation which is having k1 term, and other we need to neglect it. So normal equation for k1 will be what, multiply 3 with k1, 3 k1 equals to what, 0. Over here there is no k1, so leave this value, leave this equation. Over here there is no k1, so leave this equation, but over here there is k1, so it will be what, twice k1 plus twice k2, and multiply 2 with this value also, that is equal to what, 4.2. then again here, over here there is k1 plus k2 plus k3, so value is what, multiply this value, okay, k1 plus k2 plus k3 equals to what, 1.5. so the normal equation is what, adding this value, 6 k1 plus 3k2 plus k3 equals to what, 5.7. okay, similar, in a similar manner we have to find out the normal equation for k2, so leave this value, there will be this value which is multiplied by twice k2, leave this value will be multiplied by 2. Okay, then you need to also consider this value, oh, sorry, this value and this value also, so there will be 4 equation for this. Twice k2 equals to 0, twice k1 plus k2 equals to 4.2, k2 plus k3 equals to 0.5, k1 plus k2 plus k3 equals to 1.5. addition, thrice k1 and
this is 2 plus 2, 4, 4, 5, 6, 6k2, and this is twice k3. So this is 6.2. And similarly, equation number k3. So in this, there is no k3. In this, there is no k3. k3 is over here, so twice k3, this will be there. And there is no k3 in this, there is k3 in this, and k3 in this. So three equations will be there. So twice k3 equals to 0. And k2 plus k3 equals to positive 0.5, and k1 plus k2 plus k3 equals to 1.5. So we have got now three equations. One is the normal equation for k1, one is the normal equation for k2, one is the normal equation for k3. Okay, so what you have to do, these k1, k2, k3 equation we need to put in the calculator by simultaneous equation, and we can calculate, we can get the value of k1 plus k2 plus k3, and you will get some values in positive and some value will be in negative, and then you will have to work, add this one, suppose it is coming out to be positive, then you need to add angle A with this value, and the k2 is coming out to be positive again, then you have to add B with this value, and suppose C is there, suppose C is, k3 is coming out to be minus, so then you need to minus C value with this value. So this will give you your most probable value. So that means with the help of these calculations, we have found it out the most probable value for angle A, most probable value for angle B, and most probable value for angle C. Okay, so in this way, it indicates basically the most probable value. It is indicating that it has the most chances of being true as compared to any other reading. Okay, that is the motive behind the most probable value, and that is why we have done so much calculations over here. Okay, and this is the only question which I am teaching, because I don't think this might be asked in your university exam in MCQ form. Okay, so if anyone has any doubt related to this, I will share the PDF of this book to you. You can see some numericals, you can try to solve it by yourself also. It is very easy. Okay, and if someone has any difficulty related to this, please let me know in the comment section, or you can directly contact me through WhatsApp. Okay, thank you so much.